So this is the little street, and in this street, this is the entrance to this bunker.
Look at this.
And this looks like an ordinary building, but inside it, there's nobody lives. It's got a dome with 9 feet thick concrete inside it to protect this bunker under the ground. And we took an hour to find this, so it's quite a complicated business, but I'll just walk up the street here and we'll have a look, see. So it's opposite this little church. So this is the main street. And opposite this little church, you go down here, and it's on the left-hand side. But as I say, it took us nearly an hour to find a place. Down here from the metro, to this church here. And then you turn left, down past this little market. And then when you get to the next junction, you just go straight across, and it's on the left-hand side.
Here you can see the second door. Yes, this one. Here, can you stay there? Can you stay there? It's there.
There.
Yeah? Yes. Thank you. So now I will call you.
Bomb explosion door guarding against radiation into this bunker. Above this is a building just looks like a normal block of flats, but inside there is a huge dome of concrete which is 9 meters thick. Nobody lived in the flats, but it was disguised. And now we go down this long, long steps to the bottom. So we are down at the bottom now. 60 meters under the ground. And you can see this is steel walls. So people who came down here, they didn't. There are four bunkers, and they didn't. Nobody was allowed to know the whole thing. So if you worked down here, you only knew where you were going to work. You didn't know anything else. Okay.
Capable to protect important control centers against nuclear weapons. At the beginning of the 50s, a decision was made to build in Moscow under Taganskaya Square, a protected command post for handling of air defense troops and for telegraphic and telephone communications of Ministry of Defense. Local inhabitants residing in the 50s in this district hardly suspected that a secret underground facility was being constructed beneath the ground. And even today, only few people know what is hidden behind the walls of Building 11 of the 5th Katelnicheski Lane. In the 20s, an ordinary dwelling house was built here. It was exactly this building which was defined as the central entrance to the protected command post. In 1956, the special object was commissioned. Endless tunnels and passages stretched out under the dwelling houses at the depth of 60 meters. 2,500 military and civil specialists worked at the facility when it was commissioned. Its staff could work in an autonomous mode for 90 days. All types of vital activity at the object were guaranteed by independent ventilation, water and power supply and provisioning. At the end of the 70s, a necessity arose to carry out reconstruction of the object and replace the obsolete equipment by new, more up-to-date. Repair work began in 1985. The object was subject to complete dismantling. Equipment, facing material, which covered the concrete walls, furniture, everything was taken away. Work at the object went on till 1990, and then funding was cut off. The powerful bunker that could withstand a nuclear strike had to live through much more difficult, peaceful time. Once rather mighty, the Union.
We're down at the same depth as the metro. You can hear them going past. Nuclear war. So these are Minutemen. Bunker. There are all sorts of relics around the place. Small telecommunications and propaganda. No this is a 3D model. So there's the building you can see, which is in the street. And you come down these steps here, and there are four bunkers. One, two, three, four. And they could live for 90 days down here. Generators, food, water. Leads from the bunker to the metro station, but it's now closed. But we're continuing along this bunker. Hear the metro going fast. To make it into an entertainment centre, like discotheque, nightclub, whatever. And there you can see that we're on our way back to the beginning.